Hi everyone, this is Brandon here. Welcome to my next episode, Day24 of my Let's Clash series. So I started the morning by doing a lot of raids. So I started to farm a lot in the morning because I was about to complete one of the upgrade. The Archer Tower was about to finish his upgrade. So finding this Tower 8 was a pretty nice find with 273,000 gold available. But some of the gold mines, they were behind the walls, especially the one that is like next to the tower behind the second layer of wall. And I wanted to get it as I needed a lot of gold for the next few upgrades. So going ahead to try to break my way into the wall. And then just deploying my troops as usual, and then dropping my clan castle, which the wizards just came out. Barbarian King is going to go into to try to break the wall. Not having any wall breakers really is a good idea. So I might want to bring some wall breakers in the future, probably getting some level 5 wall breakers. So I have to research them as soon as possible. After getting the archers and the barbarians to a higher level, I will definitely work on the wall breakers. After the wall breakers, I'll definitely try to get the wizards and also the golems and witches, because I'm planning to use Goblin Horde as in golem, witch, wizard, and also P.e.k.k.a. But my P.e.k.k.a, I won't be upgrading the P.e.k.k.a, because I will be getting the P.e.k.k.a from my clan castle. One P.e.k.k.a in my clan castle is good enough, which I will be able to get from my clan mates. So not gonna bother to upgrade the P.e.k.k.a, as it will take a very very long time to upgrade. And also I will be able to use the upgrade time to research on more important stuff, such as the golems, wizards, witches, which I will use more, such as maybe use around 19 to 22 wizards in my army combo. So next time you guys will be able to see more of it. But for Townhall 9, definitely the housing spaces is lower than Townhall 10, which is 220, the maximum for Townhall 9. So I will have to adjust my troops a little. Usually I will advise those Townhall 9s in my clan to bring around 17 or 15 wizards. I can't really remember the exact number, but I will tweak it around, because last time when I give them advice was to take into consideration bringing around 10 to 12 wall breakers, but I could reduce the wall breakers usage if the opponent's walls, they are pretty low in level, like maybe a pink crystal wall. Just needing one level 6 wall breaker will be able to break through the pink crystal wall. So if the opponent, I see that they only have like pink crystal wall, I won't be bringing too many wall breakers to go for war. So the reason why I'm preparing for a Goblin Horde is to go for war, and definitely to be able to help out in the clan wars in my clan. So hopefully I'll be able to show you guys some clan war footage soon. Especially I know I'll be showing a lot of farming of footage with a barge, and I can't really show much stuff now other than upgrades, barge, and also a bit of doing other stuff such as my clan stuff. So I can't really show much stuff now, so you guys have to hang in there, not to worry. Once my main attacking army combo is ready, I will definitely show more of the attacks. So going back to the raid, so as now you can see my troops have bust through the base. Now going ahead to take down the town hall with the help of the wizards. So for this particular base, it's not very easy to get all the gold mines, because the gold mines, they are all separated. So I have to break through certain areas of the wall, but it's not too easy to break through with just level 3 buffs. So going ahead with the next attack on this Townhall 8, it's exposed on the outside of the Townhall. So going ahead to take down the Townhall first so that we secure the win. And definitely trying to take out all the gold mine, because the gold is very high with 369,000 gold available. So going ahead to try to focus my troops on the gold mine, not even trying to bother about the rest of the troops, because the Townhall is already outside. So I'm going to get the win no matter whether I get a 50% or not. So trying to get more of the gold mines first, not bothering about the rest of the other resources, especially the elixir, as when my elixir is kind of full. But also for dark elixir, I don't really need it also. So just trying to steal a bit more of the gold first, then after that a little bit of the elixir, just to max out my capacity, and then eventually getting a little bit of the dark elixir and not even bothering to wait through the whole entire battle, just ending the raid and getting us the 300,000 gold. So going back to my base, so right now my Archer Tower has just finished its upgrade, so it has gotten to the next level, and eventually I got a free builder. So what do I do with free builder? Definitely to upgrade the walls. So upgrading the walls, spending the gold on the walls as usual. So about to get all the walls to dark purple crystal, so we are almost there for this max level 7 walls for Townhall 7 before we reach Townhall 8. So managed to achieve what I said to you guys, which is to get all the walls to level 7 walls. So we have 10 hours and 37 minutes left on the Townhall till we reach Townhall 8, as you can see on the bottom left. So just going ahead to take a look at my base and see what else we can do. So going ahead to upgrade my gold mine, just waiting for the time to try to adjust a bit of my builder's time, because I'm trying to get the builders to be ready at the same time, two builders to be ready at the same time, so that I can use both of the builders once the Town Hall 8 has already been reached. So going ahead to upgrade more walls after I did a few more raids, after that gold mine was completed 2 hours later. So I didn't do much attack as I was kind of busy during this point of time. It was in the afternoon for me, so I had a little bit of meetings, this and that, so I didn't play much. So now I had more time during around lunchtime or whatsoever, I can't really remember. But what happened was I managed to find this raid with 260 of 1000 gold available, and then eventually I went ahead to attack it. So for those of you who are like asking me to show you guys a live raids, live replays, this and that, I can't really show you guys a live replays as in to comment it while I attack. The reason is because I'm busy outside most of the time, so I won't be at home most of the time. So whenever I'm doing all these records, all pre-recorded, and I usually voice over them. Why I do so is because I have to cancel away the noise, because the background noise from outside is really too loud. Especially you will hear a lot of miscellaneous noise such as motorcycle, even cars, and even other stuff such as things that we do in the office, paperwork, etc, even computer. So I do not want you guys to listen to those kind of background sound, that's why I have to off the gameplay sound. But when I reach home, I do have a quiet time at home and able to do all these voiceovers for you guys to listen to. So that's it for why I'm actually not doing it live. And you guys also must remember that all these raids are done in like a full day of farming, be it the morning, be it afternoon, or even at night. So I have to edit out the videos to show you guys all this kind of stuff. I can't possibly show you guys all those live raids because I'll be in and out of the house, so I won't be at home most of the time. So I'll be traveling here and there, going out to do some stuff, run my own errands, this and that, so I can't possibly just keep staying at home with the noise, not having any background sound to show you guys all the live reads. So hope you guys are okay with that, especially some of you have already stated a comment that I should show more live reads, this and that. I mean, this is the best that I can ever show, showing you guys the way I attack, rather than showing you guys all of it being replays only. Sometimes I do have to show you guys replays as mentioned, because my recording actually sometimes do crash while recording and attacking, because my phone do lag, and then eventually once it lag and it the recording will just crash. So basically it just down to luck whether I deploy my troops really fast. If I deploy my troops very fast, sometimes my device will lag in such a way whereby my whole entire recording screen recorder will just crash. So that's something that I don't really like, so I'm trying my best not to deploy too fast, that's one, and of course to try to minimize the crash chances of it. Especially I usually close apps, and also close all the apps, close everything, close all the notification, and in fact all the chats with other people on other chat groups such as Line Chat, such as WhatsApp, such as even Kick Messenger, Facebook, and if Twitter or whatsoever. So I'll always off all those notifications, this and that, before I start recording, before I start attacking, so that all those records won't go haywire. So yeah, it's not an easy task to actually collect all the recordings for you guys, especially when I'm not used to doing such stuff. Especially last time whenever I farm, I usually just end the raid and just click end game. I don't even bother about looking at the loot bonus, this and that, but just to show you guys what league I'm in. So now going ahead to upgrade the walls, the remaining wood walls, the level 1 walls, as I want to get all of them to dark purple crystal before I reach to Town Hall 8. So another 6 hours and 36 minutes more till I'll get to Town Hall 8. So should be able to get all to dark purple crystal wall. So some of you guys have stated in the comments that I should upgrade my wood walls earlier. So I did reply to you and say that I do not want to upgrade it because I'm trying to control my cost, trying to cost manage it properly. So what I mean by cost manage is to upgrade my walls in a certain manner whereby I'm able to control my gold. So I give you just one example. Say I got 4 million capacity, which is what I have right now, and then I obtain 4 million gold. So I'm able to upgrade say 20 walls from level 7 to level 8. But if for example I'm unable to get the 4 million gold, maybe I'm short of just 100,000, so I managed to only farm 3.9 million gold. So I'm able to upgrade 19 of the walls from level 7 to level 8. However, with that 100,000 gold left, I won't be able to upgrade any walls if I'm not left with any lower level walls. So if I'm left with say wood walls or even a level 2 or level 3 or lower level walls than level 7, I will be able to spend that 100,000 gold, say from a level 6 to a level 7 wall, which costs 75,000 gold. So I will be able to spend more of my gold and utilize my gold better if I were to upgrade my walls, the highest level walls first, in fact, rather than to upgrade the lowest one first, and after that subsequently when I want to cost manage it properly, I will have a problem. And I know most of you guys will prefer to upgrade your lowest level walls first so that it looks nicer on your base, especially to have like say all dark purple crystal rather than to have some dark purple crystal, some wood walls. It doesn't look too balanced. So I know some of you guys will be thinking that way, but I don't think that's the optimum way of managing your cost. Especially also if you want to take into consideration that your gold won't be able to be utilized totally. So that's why I just focus more on the cost wise. I'm not even focusing on aesthetic, like how my base will look, whether are there level 1 walls on my base. I don't really bother too much. And also if you are talking about the health hit points of the walls, of course it's better to upgrade the lower ones first so that the hit points reach to a certain amount, and then eventually the wall breakers, they require more wall breakers to break through the wall. But of course I do consider much more on the cost itself, as to manage the cost way much more efficiently so that I could upgrade my walls in a more efficient manner. And also when I go offline with lower amount of gold available for people to loot, people won't be able to steal that much, just taking my town hall out and eventually just giving me a shield. So that's why most people will not go and maybe 3-star my base, although it's a rather weak base. But later you guys will be able to see some defensive replays, or maybe even the next episode I'll be able to show you guys some defensive replays whereby some people, they just attack my base is to just snipe my town hall, not even bothering to take any of the gold, because my gold is just plain too pathetic, whereby it's just like only a 5-digit amount for them to loot, which it doesn't make sense for them to go ahead and attack all the way into the storages. And also the fact that my gold mines, they're very low in level, so of course the amount of gold stocked up in them won't be very high. So that's why most people will not do a collector's raid on me. They will just go ahead and try to get the storages, but of course the storages, they are so low in loot that they won't even bother to go for it. So just going back to the raid, so now as you can see, I found this 300,000 over gold base on this Town Hall 8. So of course the gold mines, they are very high in level, and then of course the gold production from them is very high, and this guy hasn't been collecting his gold. Maybe this guy has quit playing Clash, because as you can see on the top left, he doesn't have a shield, which is not in a bad in a league at all. So for me, even if I upgrade my gold mines to a certain level, or even I don't upgrade them, I will usually be online to try to collect them. Even if I don't stay online to collect them, I will usually collect them before my shield actually runs out, so that people won't be able to steal a lot of loot from me. That's one. And also they won't be tempted to try to attack my base too aggressively, especially when the storages, they are very full. Most people will try to attack and wreck your base if your storages, they are very full. I mean, would you want to attack a base that doesn't have any loot? No, right? I mean, I wouldn't. That wouldn't make sense for me to farm a base that would have like a 5-digit or a 4-digit loot. I'd rather farm a base which has like 300 or 400 over 1,000 gold available. Not too difficult base to attack, of course. So some of you guys have also been asking me to go and do some proper raids. I mean, what your definition of proper raids are, like attacking those active bases which going for those storages raids. I mean, I do not do those kind of raids that often, other than the fact that if the base is relatively easy to attack, the reason is very simple, is because it doesn't make sense for me to use all my troops to risk going ahead to attack the count bases, especially when I know that my troops will be able to be taken out really quickly. So I will just skip the base, search a while more, and then maybe find a dead base, like for example this one with 437,000 gold available. So just searching for a while more, I mean, you guys would be able to find a better loot, especially for those of you who are rather impatient, who like go for 100,000 or in fact just like 150,000 gold available bases. I mean, I do go for those kind of bases as mentioned in my previous episode, but only go for them if the gold mines, they are all situated all at one spot and I'm able to get all the gold, and also that the gold, they are all inside the gold mines. So if the gold, they are all spread out and some of them, they are in the gold storages, it doesn't make sense for me to go for 150,000 gold base. Unless it's like having a 400 over 1,000 resources available, then yeah, I will go for it. So like this one, you can see the gold mines, they're all spread out, but I'm still going for it, because even if I just get like say 4 gold mines, which I'm confident to get, I will get a lot of loot already. I'll get like 200 over 1000 loot from it. So I don't really have to bother about going into the base, getting the storages, and then I'll risk not even getting a single loot. So I see a lot of people, they just spam their troops because once they see like a high loot base, they get very excited. Like this 400 over 1000 base, they'll just spam at one spot and then try to go for the storages and then realize that, oh, they only could get like a 5-digit amount of gold. It looks like we are back to my base. So with just 8 seconds left on the clock, the Town Hall will reach to Town Hall 8. So I know a lot of you guys have been waiting for me to get to Town Hall 8 because a lot of you are at Town Hall 8 and want me to show you guys how I play Town Hall 8 as to how I farm, how I prepare myself, how I even carry on to do the upgrades. So now as you can see, I just level up and then eventually I go ahead to get some of the walls first. The walls are definitely the most important thing for me right now. So going ahead to get 50 of the walls. So it's not too easy to get all of them out. So of course, I'm not going to bother about putting them properly right now because after I have set up all my walls, I'm going to change my base layout as mentioned. Once I reach the Town Hall 8, I'm going to change the layout of my base because I'll have enough walls to do some awesome base designs. So in just a few more minutes, I'll be able to show you guys a certain base design that I used throughout my whole entire farming adventure last time when I played my main account. So this base design is relatively strong, but of course it has its own weakness too. I'll explain to you guys in the future episodes as to explaining and showing you guys a defensive replays as to how good it is and also how bad it is. So with low level defenses, with level 1 air defenses, this and that, I'm pretty sure I'm going to be attacked by air raids a lot of times, such as a Balloonians or even a Dragons. Especially last time when I reached to Town Hall 9 and then eventually I only had level 1 air defenses last time on my main account when I reached to Town Hall 9. And then I just keep getting attacked by mass dragons every day. I'll probably get attacked once or twice. The minimum is also once. So I got kind of used to it because the level 1 air defense is just really too easy to be taken out with mass dragons. But yeah, it's okay. I mean, like what I always say, I lose all the loot, but when I go and raid, I will raid back all the loot within one or two raids. So now as you can see, I upgraded my laboratory, trying to upgrade them to the next level so I can do the next research upgrading and researching my archers to level 5 as I want to get them to the highest level possible as soon as possible. And then now going ahead to upgrade my army camp, which actually I forgot to upgrade it when I reached to Town Hall 7. So I could have done that upgrade way earlier, but then now that I realized that I could have upgraded. So I was playing with only like 160 troop capacity, but it's okay. I mean, I still could play it that well and do the loot pretty okay. So it's not pretty much of to how many army troops you can actually bring together with you and also what kind of level troops you actually have. Most importantly is how you control your troop, that's one. And of course, having strong clan castle troop definitely helps me a lot. And also the Barbarian King, he just being a big tank mix shield over there, tanking off the damage for the archers, especially like now the wizard is just focusing on him and also some cannon is also attacking him, so it's just taking the damage off the archers. If the Barbarian King isn't there, the archers would have been taken out really quickly by the wizard tower. So going ahead right now, you can see the Barbarian King has bust through two layers of wall, now busting through the third layer, going ahead to try to take out the Town Hall. But as now you can see, he doesn't have the ability available for him, and not being able to heal his HP back and then reach him up, he went down really quickly. So managed to only get one star, but definitely a high amount of loot. So now going back to my base, my army camp completed its upgrade, and I'm gonna go ahead to do some wall upgrades first before I carry on the upgrade of my army camp. So upgrading one wall to level 8. So as you can see, I changed the design of my base. I won't be showing you guys the whole entire base as to how I changed it, this and that. It's gonna be time consuming and I don't think it's very efficient for you guys to watch how I actually changed my whole entire base. But I'll definitely show a screenshot of it at the end of the video so that you guys can take a look at it. And of course, if you guys want to use my base layout, do go ahead and use it. Definitely, I'm pretty sure you guys will enjoy using it, especially for those who are farming really hardcore, especially when it do help fend off people who want to take your gold or in fact your elixir. They do have to decide among one or two resources. They can't definitely take all the storages unless they are using really really strong troops to come and attack you. So people who are using like Barbarians and Archers, they won't be able to take all the loot unless they are really really skilled to get all of it. So this is the base layout that I'm currently using with only 225 walls available. Once I reach to Town Hall 9, there will be another tweak to it. So I'll show you guys again once I reach to Town Hall 9 and also Town Hall 10. So yeah, that's it for this particular episode as to what I want to update you guys on. So as you can see, my attack wand is at 500 over. And also my donations is very, very poor with zero troops donated. As mentioned, that once I reach to level 5 archers, then I'll start donating to my clanmates as I've received like 5,000 over troops. And of course, some of you guys have also mentioned saying that 5,000 over troops received is totally crazy. But yeah, I have to thank my clanmates for allowing me to do that. And also, my gold grab achievement is about to be completed with just 21 million gold till I reach to 100 million, which the achievement will complete. And then I will be able to get some more gems. So that's it for this particular episode that I would like to update you guys on. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my episode and clash on.